Hello, beautiful souls. This is Julie with Into Heartspace, and we're looking at the energy surrounding April. And before I get into the personal sign readings, I'm going to do the collective one card pull. The one card that crosses boundaries. Everyone will feel in some way through April. And if you're not interested in this, then I have linked below a timestamp where the individual sign readings begin. But if you're still here, first and foremost, I apologize about my voice. I have bronchitis, and I've been going in and out of losing my voice, so I sound a little raspy, and if that annoys you, I apologize, and I hope and I'm sure that I will be much better by the next round of readings. Okay. Let's call in the highest of light, the highest of energy to guide us on this reading. What is the collective energy? What one card will resonate with everyone who watches this video? This one. Manifestation power. Ooh, yes, I love it. And you know why I really love this card too? Is because we're falling upon Aries season. So this is the beginning of the zodiac. It's kind of like, it's a new year. It's a new energy. Aries is moving forward. It's the first sign of the zodiac. And so we're coming into a new cycle of being. And so this is manifesting everything that you have been working for. As the card says, use your spiritual gifts and natural abilities to attract your desired outcome. So use what you're good at. Use what you know. Use your intuition. Use what is easy to you, which just comes naturally, to drive you forward, to push you into new boundaries, to manifest your power. And on to the reading we go. Hello, Scorpio. This is Julie with Into Heartspace, and we're here looking at the energy surrounding you for April 2017. If you would like a personal reading, you can find me on Facebook, you can email me, or go to my website. Also, make sure to check out your rising sign and your moon sign if you're not sure what those are. In the description box below, I have a link that will take you to a site that creates natal charts. The natal chart shows where all of the planets were when you were born. So let's call in the highest of light, the highest of energy to guide us on this reading, calling in the divine. What messages do you have for Scorpio for April 2017? What are the messages, what energies, what guidance do you have for Scorpio? Scorpio 2017 April. What messages? I'm going to go this way. There's so much extra that it just felt like I needed to go back. Let's see. One, two. Okay. And the energy that's coming in from March, once I get to it, is the Lovers. So that's wonderful, Scorpio. Have you been enjoying your mate? Have you been enjoying a partnership, a contract, sublime happiness with another, feeling comfortable finding the other part of you? It could be through person, but it could be through place as well as through through work, career. But this, yeah, having the Lovers here in March is really finding a source of unconditional love. And then we have the Six of Cups. Oh, this is Scorpio. So far, so good. Six of Wands, Queen of Wands reversed, and Three of Cups, the Redeemer that redeems it all. The Fool, Justice reversed, Page of Discs. Five of Cups reversed, the Guide reversed, Three of Discs, the Universe, Queen of Cups reversed, Five of Discs. Interesting. There's a battle. It's like a tug of war going on here. But what's encompassing it all is, you know, this beautiful Lovers from March and the Six of Cups. So nostalgia, feeling comfortable, loving what has already happened and feeling confident and in a good foundation. When it's linked up with lovers, it's that you are capable of making really helpful, enjoyable decisions because of everything you've already been through. So the decisions you're making right now are grounded in beauty and in love and in comfort because of the past you've already had. And I'm not saying that you had a positive past. I'm not saying that, you know, everything was puppy dogs and unicorns. What I'm saying is that because of what you have went through, you can make really clear, concise, but at the same time loving and nurturing decisions for you and those who you love. In relationship, we have the Six of Wands reversed, and then the Queen of Wands reversed, and the Three of Cups. So it's interesting that we have this, like we have a really great union happening in March and feeling very confident about where we are and what's going on because of the foundation. And then at the same time, some of you guys, because of that, because of finding the love in yourself, finding the love in others, people are intimidated by you. So with the Six of Wands in reverse, it's not getting the victory you wanted, not getting the accolades you wanted. The Queen of Wands isn't satisfied with what's going on, isn't satisfied with the situation. Queen of Wands is a fire sign, so that's Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, and they're not on board with what's going on with you. And so they can't give you what you want, you know, because in a way they're intimidated by you and they don't know what you're doing. They don't know where you're going with it. But the Three of Cups is really saying that it doesn't matter because you have a very clear tribe that loves you and will stand with you and rise you up. But there is somebody that you do respect and you do love very deeply that is just not able to stand in your corner. And I think it's mostly due to intimidation of you succeeding, Scorpio. And I would say that it's jealousy, but I really think that it's more of they don't know what to make of you now because you used to be so meek, because you used to be so mousy, and now you're standing really strong in yourself and you have love in your heart, you have lovely friends, a lot of you probably have a wonderful partner. And they didn't anticipate that happening for you. They anticipated you kind of staying in the corner and in this dismal space, and you're not doing that. You're rising to the occasion and you're rising above even what, you know, your own thoughts, your own, you're rising past the potential you thought you were. So this is, I mean, it, in one regard, it's so wonderful to see, Scorpio, that finally in April, you'll be able to realize how things are so wonderful for you right now, and you will be able to show the gratitude for it instead of, and in the past few months I've been really seeing this of you being really down on yourself, like woe is me, woe is me, woe is me, and this month I see like you're turning the corner on this and like, oh wait, I really I'm really lucky and I really do have a lot of beautiful things to celebrate, and no one can take that away from me. And so this Queen of Wands isn't necessarily trying to take it away from you, but just doesn't know how you got there. And so, like I said, it could be a lover, but I really feel like it's more of a friend or it's a family member. All right, and they're not on your side. And it's not to hurt you. They just can't comprehend how awesome you have become. All right, and then in career we have the Fool. We have Justice reversed. And the Page of Discs. Okay. So just looking at the layout of this, the Fool is related to Uranus, so it's the unexpected, it's explosion, it's the impetus for change, and that's what the Fool is. The Fool will go, you know, off the cliff if they don't pay attention. Do you see how they're really close to the edge? And the dog is like, hold on, friend, back up, you're about to fall into the abyss. And so in career, I feel like you're ready for a change. You're ready to shift things up. You're ready to carry on. But you don't have your ducks in a row. Like, this is not the time to put in your 2 weeks and say, you know, forget it. I'm just going to fly by the seat of my pants. No, wait for an offer, because one will come. Like, the Page of Discs is an offer. And it's a heartfelt offer. And it could really be a monetary abundance. But you have to have your ducks in a row to receive it, because we have Justice in reverse. And so the Page is offering it to this Justice in reverse and saying, you know, I want to offer it to you, but are you up to it? Are you up to this? And Justice isn't, you know, in this situation. No, things aren't ready. Things aren't ready to change. So you need to get all the details taken care of. And I know that's like not the fun stuff, but you have to find that balance between, you know, your reality and what you want your dreams to be. Because the reality of the situation is that you have to take care of those details that suck. And the dream is to go past that. So take care of the details so that you can move on past it. Keep the dream alive, keep the goal in front of you, but make baby steps to get there. Don't just sit there and go, wouldn't it be nice if I could do that someday? Be like, I will do that someday, and the first step is. And then in abundance, we have the Five of Cups reversed, the Guide reversed, and Three of Discs. All right. So with the Five of Cups reversed. All right. So Spirit's really talking to me on this and saying, Scorpio, you in I think Cancer had a similar feeling to this too. You have already processed. Okay. You have already done the work. You have, you know, done some sort of counseling, done some kind of healing work, done some kind of spiritual work, creative work. But you're still using, and this is what's interesting, it's coming back to the Six of Cups too. You are using your past as an excuse not to succeed. You have so many skills, so many gifts, and this is what's holding you up a little bit is, well, this happened to me. This awful thing happened to me. You don't understand what I went through. No, we don't. But we know who you are now. So show us your beauty. Show us how all of that created this beautiful foundation so you could have these amazing people in your life and connect with. Show us who you are now, that you are living in the sun, that you are living, that you already went deep into the murk. You already went to the darkness. You could live there easily, Scorpio. But you have chosen to come out and show us what it looks like to transform. So if you catch yourself saying, you don't know what I went through, bite your tongue, Scorpio. Bite your tongue. That's not what this is about anymore. The universe, the world needs to see who you are right now. And I think, and you're getting there. Like I said, there's this change in the corner, but we fall back on habits. And so this has to do with your abundance, okay? That you have to really keep doing that work because we're seeing it. The world is seeing how you are growing and becoming this force. So you have to continue that force forward. And at this point, like, you just turn the corner, but you're like, oh gosh, this is scary. This is pretty powerful. I'm doing pretty good. Oh no, maybe I should turn back. Maybe it's all going to be taken away from me. Absolutely not. Keep turning that corner and go forward. Remember, you went through what you went through to become who you are right now. Don't use it as an excuse to hold yourself back. In mind, body, spirit connection, we have the world, love that, and the Queen of Cups reversed, and then the Five of Discs. All right, so Scorpio, this is you, Queen of Cups reversed. It's, but it's shifting. That's the thing, is it's really shifting. I can feel it because of what happened here and what's in the middle. Queen of Cups reverse can be kind of manipulative, can kind of use passive aggressiveness. Like, no, I don't care. I don't care. We can go to Chinese food. That's fine. I just felt like Italian, but you know, Chinese fine. That's what I want. You know, kind of that kind of attitude of, oh yeah, I'd totally love to go see Modest Mouse. That would be great. I kind of felt like, you know, seeing Beyonce, but you know, that's cool. We'll go see Modest Mouse. Don't do that, Scorpio. Stand up for yourself, because it's when you say those things, you're just taking from your own wealth, taking from your own spiritual wealth, and we don't want that, okay? Like, it's like a spiritual emotional cold. I've been talking to a friend of mine about that. Like, you, this right here, this Queen of Cups attitude that, you know, is like a defense mechanism, I feel like, Scorpio. And on the other side, if you could be falling on passive aggressiveness because of fear. But at the same time, you could be going the exact opposite and getting in somebody's face over nothing, okay? And being like, well, I don't understand what the big deal is. You're just being irate and crazy, and I just asked for this one thing, and you can't even do that for me? You know, like calling somebody else out for something that you're doing. You know, why are you being crazy about this? When you're feeding the frenzy with them, you know? But we have the universe here, and that's what I love. It's like this, the world, this is called the universe in this deck, but it's the world in other decks, and it's ruled by Saturn, and Saturn is the taskmaster, the teacher. And will give you what you deserve. So if you keep going this way, and falling back on old patterns and things that have happened in the past, acting like your future is the same as your past, which is, it's completely different, then all of this will be swept away. Like, notice that the Queen of Cups, her back is turned, and she's topsy-turvy on top of it all. So there's a lot of beauty that's happening here. There's a lot of possibility, especially with the Fool and then the Lovers and the Six of Cups and the World. You have some really, and Three of Cups are all super positive cards. Really, really lovely to see. but your back is being turned on it, and you could lose it. You could lose it if you keep denying it, because Saturn's not going to beg. Saturn doesn't beg, and the universe is ruled by Saturn, like I said. Saturn says, okay, this is what you deserve. This is what I want to give you. Do you want it? And if you go, well, I don't know. It's you don't understand what I've been through, Saturn. Then Saturn's jaw will clench, and then they will close their book, and then they will walk away. Okay? And say, get back to the drawing board, because you didn't learn what I just tried to teach you. So there's a lot of abundance that is right at your fingertips, Scorpio. And it's, you know, celebrating your tribe and you within your tribe, finding people who understand and love you. The possibility of change, but you have to make sure that you are looking at the fine details of it. And continually cultivating who you are now, not who you were. And the universe will be given to you. Saturn wants to deliver that to you, but you have turned your back on the universe. And that could cause a loss, being left out in the cold. So this is, you know, forewarned is forearmed. It's up to you. Like, you have a lot of potential here to rise beyond what you have even imagined. But don't turn your back on your own abundance. Okay. I know a card flipped out. I had a couple of my watchers, my viewers, be like, when a card flips out, you pick it up. And not with me, I'm sorry. If it flips out and it feels right and I hear my guides, my spirit guides, say keep it, then I do. And if they say sloppy, then I keep shuffling. So, trust. Oh, and I'm pulling an animal spirit knowledge card for you. So this is the animal that will guide you through April. Gosh, I'm getting no cues to stop shuffling. They really want me to work it out for you. What animal for Scorpio, April? What animal will guide Scorpio? This one, okay. Coyote. Oh, I love the way this card looks. Okay, I'm going to read the back to you. Coyote. It symbolizes transformation, creation, cunning, good fortune. See, I told you, Scorpio. All right. The coyote often embodies the trickster, a mischievous but heroic supernatural being that uses magic, cunning, or deception to achieve its ends. Most Native American tribes of the Pacific Northwest claim the coyote to be their creator. In some legends, the coyote forms the different peoples of the land from the various sections of a great beaver, which was slain. The Plains Indians also regard the coyote as a teacher and magician. In all of its roles, the coyote is a benevolent figure who intentionally or unintentionally helps to restore balance and order. The rather pensive coyote woman in this painting, entitled Coyote Woman Waits, is a character from Buffalo Gals Won't You Come Out Tonight, a story by Ursula K. Le Guin, the Boulet Illustrated. I think she has, I actually believe she has some tarot cards. I'm not 100% sure. Don't take my word for that. but coyote, transformation, creation, cunning, and good fortune. So you are magic. And, you know, I also like that the coyote is both teacher and magician. And so you can be cunning, you know, you can be cunning, but you can also deceive. So here's an interesting twist to this after pulling this card for you, Scorpio. And it's like, I feel like I can be very candid with Scorpios because they can hear what I have to say and understand that what I give to you is not ever to lower you, but to raise you up and to break you free of energies that are holding you back. But what's interesting about this is for some Scorpios, I feel like you guys have turned the corner a long time ago, and you have been raising up, and no one has been the wiser. Because inside, you've been cultivating and cultivating and shifting and growing, but on the outside, you have been showing this sense of being meek, of being troubled, and of being confused. But you aren't. You are none of those things. And you know it. So this is speaking to not all the Scorpios, but there's quite a few that I feel fall underneath this. And so that's deceiving. You're deceiving everyone. Like, you know your strength. You know your powers. You know what you have. You know the love that you have. You know that the past has created this. And that's why it's very easy for you to keep growing, to keep building in self and within, and not share it to anybody. Because as long as people think that you are not great, as long as people think that you will not succeed, you cannot fail. Because every success you make, people will be like, wow, I didn't think she could do that. But you know that your potential is far greater than what everyone perceives you to be. All right, Scorpio. So I think it's time to slowly, so that it's not so challenging for you, raise the bar of yourself and connect who you are on the inside with who you are on the outside. Because by deceiving all these people around you, it's doing no good. It's actually holding you back because it's a lie. It's a lie, and it's a protective lie. It's, you know, a fight or flight lie. But once again, you don't have to do that. Because you have your tribe. And you can use your magic, I mean, for good. So celebrate. Don't hold on to the past. You are not your past. You have amazing connections. You have amazing love surrounding you. Like the grow old together kind of love. In partnership, friendship, family. And yes, there's somebody who doesn't get it. But you have a lot. You have a lot to look forward to. So, all right, Coyote. Whew. Time to transform. If you would like a personal reading, you can find me on Facebook, you can email me, or you can go to my website. Until next time, much love, joy, and blessings.